Picture this, you wake up, grab your coffee, crack open your laptop, and every single note you've ever written is gone. Years of work, your projects, your ideas, all of it, dropped behind the screen that says account disabled. No warning, no appeal, no backup. This isn't some nightmare scenario. It's happening to Notion users right now.
A few days ago, someone posted this screenshot on Reddit. Notion completely locked them out for violating content and use policy. The email was ice cold and final. Workspace permanently disabled, no data export, no access to anything. The post went nuclear. 1400 upvotes on the top comment alone. Thousands of people flooding in with their own horror stories. Here's one that stuck with me. A professor, retired after 20 years, suddenly got locked out of Notion because his university shut down his .edu email. He scrambled to get temporary access just to switch emails, but it rattled him enough to start pulling everything out. His words, "I love Notion, but it's slow and unsafe. Plus, there's no way in hell they aren't selling all our data to third parties and governments." That one landed. But here's what really gets under my skin about this. For Notion to know you violated their policy, they had to read your notes. Let that sink in. Your private workspace, your personal thoughts, your sensitive information. Someone or something at Notion is actively scanning through it. No end-to-end encryption means they see everything, and they can pull the trigger whenever they want. Now, if you're in Europe, GDPR might help you claw back your data. Top comment with over 1,000 upvotes pointed that out. But here's the kicker. They're only required to give you your personal data, not necessarily your actual notes. They might have already nuked everything. Your life's work vaporized because of a policy you might not have even knowingly broken. So what's the answer? Obsidian. And no, I'm not just riding some hype wave here. The comments section turned into a full-blown exodus. Hundreds of people saying, "I'm switching now, yeah, that's why I moved to Obsidian, use Obsidian and own your data." 717 upvotes on this one. This is why local first platforms like Obsidian crush the competition. You have complete control over your data. Here's why Obsidian changes the game. First, your data lives on your computer, not sitting on some cloud server where a corporation can flip a switch and lock you out forever. Everything is stored as plain text markdown files. If Obsidian vanished tomorrow, you'd still have all your notes. Try pulling that off with Notion. Second, total privacy. No one's reading your notes. No one's scanning for policy violations. It's your vault, your rules. Third, it's more powerful once you get the hang of it. Think of it like Linux versus Windows. Yeah, there is a learning curve, but the control you gain is absolutely worth it. One user said it perfectly. "I love Obsidian, I hated learning Obsidian, but it's worth the learning curve once you figure it out." Now look, I'm not gonna pretend Obsidian is as easy as Notion on day one. It's not. But here's what Reddit users recommended, and this is pure gold. Start minimal, pick a clean theme, start making notes. Don't install every plugin you see, that's the trap beginners fall into. One person admitted they installed everything but the kitchen sink and then wondered why Obsidian felt so overwhelming. The beauty of Obsidian is you can grow into it. Start simple, layer in features as you need them. For databases, there's the DB folder plugin. For project management, Data View is incredible. The new Basis plugin even brings Notion-like functionality if you're missing that. One user moved their entire Notion workspace, 1.8 gigabytes of data, in under 2 hours. There are even free open source tools built specifically for this. Actually, I've made this that simple for you. I have two videos that'll get you up and running fast. The first one shows you how to build a powerful private AI assistant inside Obsidian, so you get AI functionality without uploading anything to the cloud. Your data stays yours. The second is my actual Obsidian setup. Simple, powerful, minimal. No overwhelming plugin lists, no complicated workflows you'll abandon in a week. Just what actually works. Both links are in the description. Here's what really gets me about all this. We trust these platforms with our most important stuff, our ideas, our projects, the knowledge we've spent years building, and they can just take it away. One policy flag, one algorithm hiccup, one corporate decision, and it's gone. Your data deserves better than being held hostage. So here's my question for you. Are you waiting until it happens to you, or are you taking control now? Drop a comment and let me know. Are you sticking with Notion, or is it time to make the switch? And if you've got your own cloud platform horror story, share it below. Let's warn others, don't let a corporation hold your digital life hostage. Those two Obsidian videos, they're your escape plan. Watch them next.